chương trình này được bảo trợ bởi
Family Joy, tổ ấm y tế của mọi gia đình, 714-898-0765.
Hi, welcome back to the OC Health and Education Show on Little Saigon TV. I'm your host, Julie Yip. Today, we have an opportunity to talk to the senior manager of Clever Care, that's Mr. Mark Anthony Paredes. He's also a board member of two nonprofits, which is the Heritage Museum of Orange County, and also a board member of the Garden Grove Boys and Girls Club. There are two upcoming events that we want to remind you. There will be one event, a day at the Museum for Seniors at the Heritage Museum of Orange County on the 24th of August, and that's from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. And also a grand opening for the Community Center that's going to be on the 23rd of September from 9 to 12 p.m. If you are interested in these upcoming events, please visit their respective websites for the Heritage Museum of Orange County and clevercarehealthplan.com. Mark, again, thank you so much for being on this show today. I can't believe this is already our last segment. You know, I enjoy all the times that I've been working alongside with you in the community, but it's just so exciting for me to see, you know, how far we've both come,
yes,
right, in our community work. I am so proud to see that you are building a community center on Bolsa.
Yes.
You know, and that's very exciting, Mark. You know, before the commercial break, you mentioned that it's upcoming. What are there kind of be certain celebrations, festivities? What should we expect that day?
So that day, we plan on having multiple speakers.
Okay.
We want to have some entertainment, inviting some famous Vietnamese singers and artists.
Oh, okay.
We're making sure that
it's kind of like a mini concert.
A little celebration.
Okay.
And then we want to make sure that we're also celebrating the Vietnamese culture, right? So I was reaching out to some of the staff that I work with and asking them suggestions on what we will have, and some suggested having lion dancers.
Okay.
Because it's something that I think is...
That's very celebratory for a grand opening.
Yes, exactly. And so we want to make sure that we really want to make sure that this community center celebrates the Vietnamese culture, because this is why we put it in Little Saigon. I did want to mention that we're also opening multiple community centers in other communities as well. One in Koreatown, and then one in San Gabriel Valley. The Koreatown, of course, serving the Korean community,
uh-huh,
and the San Gabriel serving
the Chinese community.
Yes.
I grew up in the San Gabriel Valley, you know, so when I'm in San Gabriel Valley, I say I'm Chinese. When I'm in Garden Grove, I say I'm Vietnamese. But the truth is, you know, I'm both of it. It's part of our heritage.
Sure.
And I really appreciate, Mark, that you celebrate not only our culture, but our language. You know, and I think that's very important to make sure that we have representatives from your organization to reach out to the community, but not just to reach out, but I love that you're a part of the community and making sure that it's an active role. So I really admire your leadership, Mark, because, you know, I think I've worked with health plans before. Most of the time they go to the community, then you never see them again, you know. So how, what are the hours of this community center? And will seniors be able to come often to visit, or do they have to make an appointment? Because, you know, sometimes in our community, we just like to do walk-ins.
Sure. So right now we're tentatively setting the appointment, the hours from 8 o'clock to maybe 4 o'clock.
Oh, wow. Okay.
And we're looking from Monday to Saturday. We know that sometimes people can't make it on weekdays, and we want to make sure that people have access to it on Saturday as well.
That's amazing.
We're going to be flexible as we learn. I think that's what I also wanted to share, that it's a learning process for us.
Uh-huh.
So if we need to change the hours, we'll change the hours. Or if we need to expand hours, we'll make sure that we try to accommodate the community's needs.
Yeah.
And really, this is the feedback that I'm looking for from our community leaders, to let me know how we could better serve our seniors. And also, I do want to hear from our seniors and from our community members, our caregivers, and what their needs are. So that way, like I said, this is something that is meant for the community, and we want to make sure that we're delivering what they need.
I mean, I love the transparency of what you have right now. You said that, you know, we're tentatively scheduling this, but we're willing to listen. You know, and I think that really makes a great leader, because, and if when you are serving the community, you have to listen to the needs of the community. You know, and so thank you for being a good listener and willing to be able to adjust to the specific needs of our community.
Yes.
So, thưa quý vị khán giả, hôm nay Julie có thời gian nói chuyện với Mark Anthony Paredes. Mark Anthony chia sẻ với mình là trong ngày 23 tháng 9 về khai trương của cái Community Center Gender Bosa đó. Đó là Mark Anthony muốn mời quý vị tới tham dự cái chương trình. Có rất nhiều người ca sĩ với cái kỳ lân tới để cho làm cái khai trương cái bữa đó. Cũng có đồ ăn với nếu quý vị có thời gian tới tham dự chương trình để cho hiểu được cái Community Center đây. Sẽ có thể hiện tại mở là từ 8 giờ sáng tới 4 giờ trưa từ thứ hai tới thứ bảy thì đó là rất là quan trọng mà Mark Anthony nói đó là chừng nào cộng đồng của mình cần thay đổi cái ngày lúc cái trung tâm đây sẽ luôn luôn lắng nghe về cái lời hướng dẫn của quý vị. Mark, again, thank you so much for being on this show. Is there any last words or advice or message you would like to share with our audience?
Yeah, I think for me, I want to say, come on. My goal is to learn Vietnamese one day at a time. So one word, so I'm starting here. So thank you very much to the LSTV audience for having me have a chance to speak with them about some of the work that we're doing. I think for me, it's about just giving back. This is a message that I say to myself and to my staff and to people I come across. The only way we can make our community better is if we make the community better, right? So that's helping each other,
yes.
Helping one another, picking up that trash, mm-hmm. Because we need to have some pride in our community and what we do. So if I could have one message, I would just say, treat each other with respect and help one another, because I think, especially during this time, it's needed.
Yes, yes. Can you remind our audience when the events are? If you can just invite them one more time.
So the event's gonna be this Tuesday, August 24th at the Heritage Museum in Santa Ana from 9 to 2. And then we have a grand opening of our BOLSA Clever Care Community Resource Center on September 23rd, and that's gonna be from 9 to 12. And more information will be on the Clever Care website page.
Okay. Well, thank you again, Mark, for sharing so much about, you know, what you're doing. I appreciate getting those updates, because I learned so much about you. Because, you know, sometimes when we're in the community, we don't have the chance to talk. You and I are just busy bees trying to get the event together and making sure that we serve our community. But I always appreciate your actions. I think that, you know, I see you as a person who puts things and make things happen. So I appreciate that. You know, and I think this is a great you know, position for you, and I'm excited to help you in any way. I think a lot of people don't know that I also I'm a speech therapist, so I also work with seniors. But you know, most of the people know me in my capacity as working with kids with autism. But you know, Vietnamese seniors, unfortunately, they don't seek services for speech therapy. So when they have a stroke or a brain injury or having swallowing difficulties. So definitely, I mean, if you need any medical support or advice on helping that, I think there are some, you know, stigma about the services that are available. So, you know, just know that I'm here to help you if you need anything too.
Well, thank you very much, Julia. I think for me, what makes it hard is I don't know sometimes when to ask for help. And the fact that you're offering that assistance will be greatly appreciated, but in many ways, in the roles that we have,
yes.
If I feel privileged where I'm at right now, because I can give back to the community, and if I can do something within my power, within my role, in with Clever Care or with a board that I serve on, I just want you, and I also want to let your audience know. We want to make sure that we can help and serve, because the public service is really what it's about, and giving back.
I know, Mark, and we were almost done with the show, but I know you also mentioned during the commercial break that you also have the capacity to hire from within our community.
Yes.
Are there some positions that are available that you want to seek out so we can better serve our seniors, and specifically our senior Vietnamese community?
Sure. Clever Care, we're hiring Vietnamese-speaking individuals that can either we'll work with our community resource center,
mm-hmm.
Work with the community and help help the seniors navigate healthcare.
Okay.
As we're all very well, healthcare can get a little bit daunting at times,
mm-hmm.
And the language needs is really more important there.
Okay.
So, but if they go onto our Clever Care website page, they'll be able to find that information.
Okay. Well, thank you so much, Mark, for being on the show. Hope to have you back on our show again. Cảm ơn quý vị khán giả của Little Saigon TV đã tiếp tục theo dõi chương trình Kiến thức Y khoa Gia đình và Xã hội. Hôm nay, Julie có thời gian nói chuyện với Mark Paredes, của Clever Care, and cũng là board member of Heritage Museum of Orange County and Garden Grove Boys and Girls Club. Mark là trong mấy năm đây Julie quen đó là làm rất nhiều việc trong cộng đồng của mình. Mà điều hôm nay Julie thấy cái thông tin rất là đặc biệt đó, là làm một cái upcoming community center cho cộng đồng Việt Nam của mình trên đường Bô Sa. Thì Julie rất cảm ơn quý vị và hy vọng quý vị có thời gian để tham dự chương trình. Cảm ơn quý vị đã tiếp tục theo dõi chương trình Kiến thức Y khoa Gia đình và Xã hội. Julie chúc quý vị rất nhiều sức khỏe và may mắn. Cảm ơn quý vị.